In this video, we're doing the most basic sort of Heisenberg uncertainty principle calculation that you can do in introductory physics. We're looking at the position-momentum uncertainty relation here, and we're told that an electron in one dimension is confined to half an angstrom as the uncertainty in position. And we're simply trying to find the uncertainty in momentum in part A and the uncertainty in speed in part B. So the position-momentum version of the Heisenberg uncertainty principle goes like this. The product of the uncertainty in position and uncertainty in momentum is at least as big as Planck's constant over 4 pi, where, as a reminder, Planck's constant is about 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 joules seconds. Now, just a quick comment on the units here to make sure they make sense. I have the product of momentum and position on the left-hand side. So that's meters for that position. And then for momentum, that's a kilogram meter per second. So those units on the left-hand side could be written as kilogram meters squared per second. On the right-hand side, I have joules times seconds. And there's more than one way to break down the units of joules into smaller pieces, but I'm picturing the kinetic energy formula, so I have mass times speed squared. So a joule is a kilogram meter squared per second squared. One of those factors of seconds is going to cancel, and again, I get kilogram meter squared per second. So my units agree on the left and right sides. So all we have to do to finish part A is just solve for delta P, the uncertainty in the momentum. That's greater than or equal to H over 4 pi delta X. We plug in the numbers. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 1.055 times 10 to the negative 24 kilogram meters per second. Then in part B, we're asked to get the minimum uncertainty in the speed for the electron. So we have the uncertainty in its momentum. We have to be reminded what the mass of an electron is, though. And that's about 9.11 times 10 to the negative 31 kilograms. So because momentum is mass times velocity, the uncertainty in the momentum is going to be mass times the uncertainty in the velocity, taking that mass to have no uncertainty in comparison to the amount of uncertainty that we're getting in the velocity. And I just solve for delta V and plug in the numbers. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 1.16 times 10 to the 6th meters per second. So when we nail down the position of an electron to a region that's roughly the radius of the hydrogen atom, the best we can do is an uncertainty in the millions of meters per second on its velocity. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.